Peripheral artery disease, or PAD, is a narrowing of the peripheral arteries, or arteries that carry blood away from the heart to other parts of the body, such as the arms and legs. PAD can lead to gangrene and amputation, and people with PAD have a higher risk of coronary artery disease, heart attack, and stroke. Unfortunately, PAD often goes undiagnosed by healthcare professionals. So how do you know if you are at risk for PAD? And if you are diagnosed with PAD, what can you do about it? Hello, and welcome to House Calls. I'm Dr. Eduardo Sanchez, Chief Medical Officer for Prevention at the American Heart Association. There are a number of risk factors for PAD, and knowing what they are and working to address them can prevent PAD. Let's start with the risk factors you cannot control. First is age. As you age, you're more at risk for PAD. Family history of PAD, cardiovascular disease, or stroke can also be a risk factor for PAD. And finally, race and ethnicity. The research shows that PAD is more common in Black and Hispanic communities. But there are a number of PAD risk factors that can be controlled. Smoking. Smokers may have almost 3 times the risk of PAD than non-smokers. If you smoke, now is a great time to quit, and the AHA can help. Check out heart.org for resources. Type 2 diabetes. If you have diabetes, you're at greater risk of developing PAD as well as other cardiovascular diseases. High blood pressure. They call high blood pressure the silent killer because it has no symptoms. It can lead to PAD because having high blood pressure makes it easier for plaque to form, which can narrow your arteries. But you can work with your doctor to monitor and control your blood pressure. High blood cholesterol. High cholesterol contributes to the buildup of plaque in the arteries, which can reduce the blood flow and lead to PAD. That's why managing your cholesterol levels is essential to prevent or treat PAD. Not getting enough physical activity. Because physical activity can prevent and help treat many atherosclerotic risk factors like high blood pressure and high cholesterol, not getting enough physical activity is a risk factor for PAD. So those are the big 5 risk factors. But there are others as well, which are related to these 5, including stress, diets high in saturated fats, obesity, and chronic kidney disease. If you have any of the risk factors for PAD, ask your doctor about PAD, even if you aren't having symptoms. Your doctor will be able to diagnose if you have PAD. When you see the doctor, they'll start with a medical history and physical exam. They'll also ask about your symptoms and check the pulses in your legs. Your physical exam may include something called an ankle brachial index, or ABI. This exam, which doesn't hurt at all, takes just a few minutes, compares the blood pressure in your lower legs to the blood pressure in your arms. If your ABI is abnormal, the doctor may recommend additional tests. These can include duplex ultrasonography, which visualizes the arteries and veins with sound waves and measures blood flow to indicate the presence of a blockage. Computed tomographic, or CT, angiography. This test uses X-ray technology and a dye to create pictures of blood vessels in the arteries in your abdomen, pelvis, and legs. Magnetic resonance angiography, or MRA. This test provides cross-sectional images like a CT, but without the X-rays. And angiography. During an angiogram, which is sometimes called an arteriogram, your doctor will inject a contrast dye into the artery and take X-rays to be able to see blood flow in the leg arteries. This helps to locate any blockages. Remember, PAD often goes undiagnosed. So if you're experiencing symptoms or you have a number of the risk factors, talk to your doctor about PAD. Early diagnosis and treatment may save your leg or your life. So what can you do to prevent PAD or treat it if diagnosed with it? The good news is that in most cases, lifestyle changes and medications are enough to slow the progression of or even reverse the symptoms of PAD. Let's start with lifestyle changes, which can be used to both prevent and treat PAD. First, smoking cessation, which we talked about earlier. Next, physical activity. Regular physical activity is an effective treatment for PAD symptoms. If you don't get much exercise now, you may have to begin slowly, but simple activities like walking, leg exercises, and treadmill exercise programs can ease PAD symptoms. Depending on your symptoms, your doctor may recommend that you do an exercise program at a rehabilitation center so your exercise can be supervised and monitored. But your doctor may also recommend a structured community or home-based program. A healthy diet is another way to prevent or treat PAD. Many people with PAD have elevated cholesterol levels, so eating a diet low in saturated and trans fat can help lower blood cholesterol levels. And for those with diabetes, a healthy diet can help manage diabetes and help you maintain a healthy weight. Aim for a diet that emphasizes fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. Include low-fat dairy products, poultry, fish, legumes, nuts, seeds, and non-tropical vegetable oils such as olive oil. Limit sodium, saturated and trans fats, added sugars, sugar-sweetened beverages, and red meat. Adopting more than one healthy lifestyle change can help you reduce your risk factors, and the more risk factors you can control, the better chance you have to prevent or treat PAD. In addition to lifestyle changes, there are several medications that can be prescribed to treat PAD. These include antiplatelet agents like aspirin and/or clopidogrel to prevent blood clots, cholesterol-lowering medications such as statins, high blood pressure medications. In people with PAD and high blood pressure, angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors or angiotensin receptor blockers are recommended. Oral anticoagulants such as warfarin or rivaroxaban, which decrease the tendency for blood clots to form. And if you have muscle pain due to lack of oxygen that's triggered by activity and relieved by rest, you may also be prescribed the medication cilostazol to help improve your walking distance and decrease leg symptoms. If your doctor prescribes medication to treat or prevent your PAD, take the medication as directed. Not taking these medications can increase your risk for PAD, as well as your risk for heart attack and stroke. For some people with PAD, these lifestyle changes and medications aren't enough. In those cases, minimally invasive treatment or surgery may be needed. Angioplasty or stent placement are often used to treat coronary artery disease and can be used to treat PAD as well. In these procedures, the surgeon makes a small incision and inserts a catheter to reach the blocked artery. Then, a tiny balloon is inflated inside the artery to open the clog. Next, a tiny wire mesh cylinder, called a stent, may also be inserted to help hold the artery open. Sometimes a medicine can be administered through the catheter, or a special device can be inserted through it to remove a clot that's blocking the artery. An atherectomy is a procedure to remove plaque from the artery. Similar to angioplasty, a catheter is inserted into the blocked artery. The catheter has a sharp blade or cutter on the end that's used to cut, collect, and remove the plaque from the blood vessel. If a long portion of artery in your leg is completely blocked and you're having severe symptoms, bypass surgery may be needed. In this surgery, doctors will take a vein from another part of your body and use it to bypass and reroute blood flow around the closed artery. Let's recap some key takeaways. Peripheral artery disease, or PAD, is a narrowing of the peripheral arteries, or arteries that carry blood away from the heart to other parts of the body like the arms and legs. You can decrease your risk for PAD by quitting smoking, getting regular physical activity, and eating a healthy diet. These, along with medicines and surgery, can also be used to treat PAD. If you're having trouble with your feet or legs, ask your doctor about PAD. And if you have questions about health conditions, I'd love to hear from you. Comment below, hit subscribe, join me here next time for Answers You Can Trust.